Welcome, here is Grace. We want to present you today's topic. That is understanding scams in cybersecurity. Let's begin. Keeping your people secure. Traditionally, people have something of an adversarial relationship with cybersecurity. Although consumers are far more security conscious than they used to be, people still prize convenience over security. They're interested in doing their jobs and being as efficient as possible, without worrying about whether or not they're putting corporate data at risk. And the truth is, they usually are. By understanding how your people think and act and why, you can better prepare yourself to reshape your security posture. When doing so, there are a few things you need to consider. What assets you're trying to protect, and who has access to them. What security tools you already have in place, and how they impact the experience of your end users. How often you engage in cybersecurity training with your people, and what that training involves. Whether or not you work with an external agency to perform test phishing campaigns and social engineering attacks. The prevalence of personal devices in your workplace, such as tablets, smartphones, and wearable technology. The password policies you've put in place, and how well your employees adhere to them. The general attitude towards cybersecurity within your organization. Do your staff feel engaged with and responsible for protecting corporate data, or do they seem to believe it's your IT department's problem? Knowing your enemies. Once you understand what your most important assets are, you'll be able to figure out why someone would target those assets. And by understanding that, you can better formulate a plan to protect them. If you work in healthcare, for example, they might want to steal patient data to sell on the black market or lock it down with ransomware to get some money out of you. If your business has recently made some unpopular decisions, targeted cyber attacks might instead be politically motivated. Generally speaking, the motivation behind any given cyber attack is one or more of the following. To make money. The simplest motivation. A criminal who targets a business in an effort to make money may be attempting to facilitate identity theft. They could also be trying to make off with proprietary data, such as product blueprints or customer lists. They might be part of a criminal organization that's trying to sell the data to the highest bidder, or they may simply be trying to blackmail a business by locking down the data with ransomware or threatening them with the release of that data. This motivation is easiest to predict and guard against. Simply understand what data has the most monetary value to an attacker, and what data has the most monetary value to yourself, and lock that data down. To make a statement. Has your business done anything controversial lately? Best be on your guard, you might well be the target of politically or socially motivated hacktivists. These criminals might simply want to blacken your eyes a bit to teach you a lesson. But more often they're looking to bring about some form of change, perhaps by releasing damaging information, such as what we saw with the Panama Papers attack. To create chaos. You've likely heard of Lizard Squad by now, the hacker group that targeted companies like Sony and Microsoft over the Christmas holiday, shutting down video game networks such as Xbox Live and the PlayStation Network. This group didn't want any money for what they did, nor did they make any demands. Instead, they simply wanted notoriety. Unfortunately, attackers of this type are the hardest to predict and the hardest to protect yourself from. They don't want you to give them money or to respond to their attacks. They simply want to watch the world burn. Out of frustration. A disillusioned IT professional. A former worker, angry about being laid off. A developer who has simply stopped caring about their organization. The one thing these employees all have in common is anger, and the capacity to turn that anger against their company and cause as much damage as possible. Ideally, you want to address this problem by treating your workers well and ensuring they don't have reason to become disillusioned. But in some cases, this might not be entirely possible. In such situations, it's important that you're able to recognize the signs that someone might be malicious and take action to prevent them from causing too much damage. The psychology behind sophisticated cyber attacks. There are a number of psychological elements that contributed to the success of the experiment, many of which have been outlined in Dr. Robert Cialdini's book, Influence, The Psychology of Persuasion. Principle of Liking. This is a simple principle with complex implications. People tend to form trust with those they're attracted to, both physically and emotionally. Robin Sage's picture shows the face of a pretty girl in her mid-20s, in half profile, eyes turned directly to the camera, and with a hint of a smile. While not lewd in any sense, despite the picture having been lifted from a pornography-related site, Robin seems young and earnest in her appeal for assistance, yet one is left with the impression of a more sensual agenda, and that Robin is about to walk away and encouraging you to follow her. Social proof. People are motivated more by what others do than a perceived or even quantifiable benefit. For example, hotel guests are 26% more likely to reuse towels when told that the majority of guests comply with that request than if simply told that reusing towels protects the environment. Read more on the science of getting a yes. The first few connections are the barrier. Once Robin accumulated them, others in similar positions or organizations were quick to accept Robin's connection request, particularly if they shared connection with others in Robin's social network. Rule of Reciprocation. Humans feel a sense of obligatory quid pro quo. When one person provides something to another, a gift or a favor, usually, the recipient feels indebted to return the act in kind. Cialdini noticed that Hare Krishnas used this principle by giving flowers to passers-by in airports, eliciting higher donations than before they appealed to travelers' sense of reciprocity, even though there was no social contract before the encounter. This tactic can be employed in social networking to compel a stranger to accept your connection request if you provide them with information, for example, and it can even work in reverse, by providing the expectation that you will be indebted to a potential connection if they accept your invitation. Those who joined Robin's network may have expected a deeper relationship in return after providing help, information, and speaking opportunities. Commitment and consistency. Most people stick with their original decisions despite information that supports changing their course. This is embodied in the Monty Hall problem, which demonstrates that subjects who choose one door would not switch when given a chance, even when they were informed that the odds were in their favor to make a different choice. In social networking, once a contact is committed to a connection, they are hard-pressed to unfriend or otherwise break that link, and will continue to interact and assist that person. There are a couple of other principles of persuasion that may be employed in social networks, but weren't necessarily a component of the Robin Sage experiment. Principle of authority. Authority, whether real or perceived, elicits obedience in many people. The principle of authority is widely used in social engineering, and movies take this to an extreme when an undercover cop intimidates her way into a high-security area. This can be used in social networking, directly or indirectly, by invoking the name of someone important, e.g., I was speaking with General Dempsey last week, and he asked me to, or by fabricating personal credentials designed to impress the target. When invoking someone else's authority, it's important to make sure that person is difficult to contact, usually because they're so high-ranking that mere mortals don't have access to them. Make sure they don't have a social networking account. Principle of Scarcity. Rarity increases value. People want to be included in exclusive offers and often make poor choices under pressure. Think of all the commercials on TV with the call to action, limited quantities. Act now, or appealing to your sense of urgency, your online banking has been blocked. Con men have known about psychological ploys for ages, through intuition instead of documented behavioral models, and we still fall for many of the same scams after centuries of victimization. It hasn't gotten any better online, either. The Robin Sage experiment was successfully reincarnated under a different, but similar, persona by the co-founder of a dating and social dynamics instruction school. We recommend you stick to the end and watch all our videos in the playlist. Check sources of this video in the description, where you can find more information. Leave the like, comment, and subscribe, and share it with friends that want to improve programming skills. Facebook warning. We can see for an example of Facebook, how they give a hint to prevent some people, to get trapped into psychological self-XSS attack. When we open browser console, we get message. Stop. This is a browser feature intended for developers. If someone told you to copy and paste something here to enable a Facebook feature or hack someone's account, it is a scam and will give them access to your Facebook account. https://www.facebook.com/selfx for more information. Where on that website we have a self-XSS scam on Facebook tricks you into compromising your account by claiming to provide a way to log into someone else's Facebook account or some other kind of reward after pasting a special code or link into your web browser. You might see this message on a friend's timeline after their own account was compromised by the scammer. Never click a link on Facebook that goes to a website you don't know and trust. This kind of scam can often use your timeline to spread itself to your friends and may also include links to malicious software or suspicious websites. Learn how to recognize scams on Facebook to protect your account from being compromised. That's a good way to make little more safer internet even from scam attacks by simply notice people. Thank you for watching, especially for all subscribers, and see you in the next video.